Today, I want to implement some kind of notification system so that when a user clicks something, they'll get a little alert, a toast notification right up top showing that such and such has been added to cart. For example, when we click add to cart, there's nothing telling you that it's in the cart. Yeah, you see it in the cart, but it would be nice to have some kind of indicator up here. So to implement this, what I'm going to be using is Sweet Alert, and this is something I typically use because it's not dependent on any sort of framework. It's not dependent on anything. It's just a quick little install, quick little plugin, and you're good to go. An example of this would be this. Good job, you click the button, we have a little bit of an animation, click OK. What we want to do now is go down to the installation, and of course there are two different ways to bring this into your project. You can either install it with npm or you can just use the CDN. For the purposes of the demo, I'm going to be using the CDN. And right in here under the routes, we are going to go ahead and paste that in. In order to bring this to the backend, we're going to have to bring this into our app.js in our resources folder. Okay, so let's go grab the next bit of code. If we do a quick search for toast and head down to this section right here, we can grab this code and use this in our app.js. We want to come into our app.js, make some space, and we'll go ahead and paste that in and change it up accordingly. So the first thing I want to do is window dot, and that will allow the view to recognize it from the front end. Toast will be true, top end, show confirmation button false, timer. I want to make this timer 5,000. Progress bar we can leave. This is the event listener, so every time you enter or leave, that will stop or resume the timer. What we can do next is grab this toast fire and head into our shop.show page, because that's where that first command is coming from. Let me shrink this down so we can see it better. Head down to the function, and on success, we can now just go ahead and paste that. Now, there's a quick change that I do need to make. Right up here for this form post, we can get rid of this from here, put a comma, and then now we just need the closing part of it. Add that right down here, and we should be good to go. Let's go ahead and just give this a quick test. We're going to refresh the page. We're going to go back to the item, add to cart. Okay, so our toast notification is working. Fantastic. To try to explain this a little bit more clearly, we're bringing in the CDN in order to be able to use the JavaScript, the CSS, and everything without installing all of Sweet Alert into the project. In app.js, we are now bringing it from that app.blade.php to the backend and giving it the toast designation. This toast is now able to be called from any portion of our app, which we are doing right here. So this toast is just firing off an event and it's being listened to by the window.toast in our app.js. These toasts have different designations, so if you want to put icon, warning, or icon, they have different things to use. So I would just take a look at the documentation. I'll make sure to link it down in the description for you, but that's pretty much the gist of all of that. So we can get rid of signed in successfully. I'm going to do some backticks, and then we're going to do $. It'll be this form name, and then outside of that, we'll have has successfully been added to your cart. Let's try it again. We want to make sure that we're getting in the property and that we're getting the correct message. We'll go back to the item, add to cart. Men's 2 has successfully been added to your cart. Great. So now I just want to bring this down a little bit and maybe push it over to the left a little bit. It's a little bit tricky to mess around with the CSS of Sweet Alert, but it's not completely complicated. There are two ways you can do it. Sweet Alert 2 gives us an option of, let's go up to the recipe gallery. Let's look at examples. It gives us some options to change the custom styling on it. As you can see, swell with bootstrap buttons, just different things that you can do. You can change the padding and stuff like that. But I found it's much easier to just get the classes directly. So it took me some pretty much looking at the code and just trying to be as fast as possible before it disappears to kind of get the classes for them. But what I managed to do was find some styling that will fix what we have going on. So what we can do is at the bottom of the component, we're going to do style. And then I'm just going to go ahead and paste this in. all it's doing is on the body class where these classes are being shown, container, top end, stuff like that, we're just going to bring the whole container down by 60 pixels, and then we're going to also push it from the right 60 pixels. So let's take a look at the browser now and see how that looks. So that looks a lot better. It's been brought down and then it's been pushed away from the right. Fantastic. The next thing we can do is now also the save for later as well as the later stuff. So let's go ahead and do that. We are just going to start by grabbing everything in here, and then we can go to the cart index page and start from the first method, which is update cart. Go ahead, paste that in, and then we'll still have the success icon, and this one instead will be items in cart. Have successfully been updated. Let's try that and make sure it works. And this is blank right now just because we have more items in the cart than we do. That's what's in the product count, but that's fine. We're going to deal with that much later on. Go ahead and refresh it. Change it to 2. Items in cart have successfully been updated. Let's go and put that styling on there as well. Okay, and let's do the next function too. And then here we're just going to put saved for later has successfully been updated. Let's do the next one. Item has successfully been saved for later. Add to cart, icon success, item has successfully been added to your cart. And I want to change this real quick to item to be grammatically correct. Delete from cart. Item has successfully been removed from your cart. And the very last one, item has successfully been removed from your save for later items. Fantastic. Let's go and make sure that all of these now work. Okay, we'll try first to save for later. Item has successfully been saved for later. 2 items saved for later. Great. Let's try to move to cart. Item has successfully been added to your cart. Everything's updated. Let's try to add another product so that we can do the other one. Okay, so that still works. We'll save this one for later. And then we'll try to remove it. We have our notification, and let's try to remove this one. Fantastic. We have our notifications up and running, and we'll be able to use them throughout the app. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to push all the code up to GitHub and leave a link for that down in the description, as well as a link to the playlist so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.